Notifications are a quite useful native feature we can utilize when we develop Zenmap. It's quite important because it gives to us the possibility to present to our users some message that can be displayed even when your app is closed. It means the user has installed your app. It has already opened that. But now it's not with your app opening. It is reading messages from some communication app. It's reading emails. He is reading news in some specific app or just navigating through the browser. But certainly, in some specific moment of time, some important information he may be interested could just be arrived in your app. And then you can just trigger a notification to your user, and a message will be displayed in the notifications area. That's a native area that every app can send the message. So your user will be aware of the update has just received, and in case he has interested, he can just click over the message, and your app is opened exactly in the activity in the screen you want to. So let's see how to do that through one very simple, fully implemented example. Okay, here we have the source code. I'm going to present to you how the notifications work. And here is the app, the smartphone emulator. So let's understand this code. It's just one activity that's provided. Okay, here one activity was being created. And the whole code is here inside this activity. We have here two main parts. We are not going to deep in details in each line, just the overview, because it's really to be utilized, just need to be parameterized by you. So here is this method named create notification. It is going to be responsible for sending the notifications when they specifically trigger is fired. So you can, of course, in case you want, just parameterize this constants here, but it's not actually necessary depending of the complexity of your app. Okay, here then the notification, and it's going to be parameterized with the title and with the body. That's the content your user is going to see. Of course, here inside, there's a lot of another parameters about colors, vibration or not, sounds or not, and so icons to be displayed to your user, so you can actually customize in case you need. But the important stuff here is that we have a method named create notification with just two parameters you can just trigger, and it actually works for current versions of Android, new versions, and also for old versions as well. So this code is quite flexible at this point. Okay, the another part of the code is about the scheduling, how we can trigger that in specifically events. So here we are going to use the native classes. Everything here is with native classes, no library necessary. So here time, timer tasks, and handler. Basically the idea here is to, we are going to have a thread that's going to be periodically checking for updates. The idea here is after 5 seconds from the beginning of the app, it already is running. And then after it's 10 seconds, it's going to check about updates. Of course, 10 seconds could be a short period. It's just one example. You can increase that to a minute or more. Okay, it's in milliseconds that it's parameterizing. Okay, now here about the code. The code is quite simple. Here it's what it's going to do in each cycle. It's going to run. In my example, I'm just going to generate a random number. That's a number between 0 and 1. And my example, in case it's bigger than 0.5, I'm going to trigger the notification. Otherwise, I'm not going to do that. In your case, it could be your logic. In case I am implementing a communication message, and in case someone sent me a message, then I'll trigger that. So this logic here, you can program your own logic. And the nice thing here is that here we are inside the activity context, so we can update the elements in the screen in case you want. More than that, it's important to update your Android manifest file with this permission to use post notifications. Actually, what we are doing here, we are working with post notifications that are going to be delivered when triggering this create notification method here. Now, let's test that. So let's test here the software executing the app. So it's going to open the emulator. Okay, I have just to click here. The default text is text view. When some value bigger than 0.find is going to be generated, it's going to update here the interface. We just need to wait because it's going to run every 10 seconds. And in case the value is smaller than 0.5, it does not trigger. Now it has triggered because the value is bigger and the notification was displayed. Okay, the app was open. Now let's go to the benefit. I'm going to minimize the app. I'm going to open the web browser. I'm here navigating. I'm using Google. My app's not open. And you see, I have a notification received. I can click over that. And when clicking, my app is again opened with the new value. Now it's automatically updated because a new value has arrived. I don't need to be with the app open. Okay, I return to my another app, to the browser itself, and then I could navigate here. And now we can click here to make my login in Google. I'm just navigating and wait for some important thing happen. Now something has happened. So let's click here. And then the new value is arriving. So that's the idea. Work with push notifications, use Android, and then you can play with that and introduce this feature in your own app. Thank you for watching.